ॐ परमतत्त्वाय नारायणाय गुरुभ्यो नमः. ॐ भूभूभूतनाथाय नमः. ॐ त्रीं त्रीं त्रिजटाय नमः. ॐ ह्रीं दिव्यचेतनानन्दाय नमः. I pray at the divine feet of Mother Lalitambika and my gurus. Today we are going to understand the meaning of the fourth Dhyan Mantra of Sri Lalita Sahasranam. We have already previously discussed about the three, and in those three we have discussed that the color of Lalitambika in the first two shlokas is like that of the rising sun. In the second one, the second shloka, Dhyan Mantra, it says the color is golden and yellowish, which is like the afternoon sun. And this is the last one in which the color is again red. Now this red, I usually relate it to the setting sun, the sun which sets. And when the sun sets, it is really nice bright red in color. Here the color, they say, is that of Japakusum. Japakusum is the hibiscus flower or the shoe flower, very red in color. But for me, all these four Dhyana mantras has been meditation on the sun. Whenever I look at the sun, right from the morning or in the afternoon or in the evening, I relate it to the colors, different colors of Sri Lalitambika. And similarly, when the moon comes, I relate the moon to the crescent moon is like the moon on the forehead, on the crown of Sri Lalitambika. So this is how the meditation has been. Now let's go and let's try to understand the meaning of it. Sakum kum vilepana malichumbi kasturikam. It says the divine mother is anointed with kumkum. Kumkum is vermilion, which is red in color. So again, the color of Divine Mother in this meditation is red, bright red color, the color of kumkum, very, very bright. Earlier in the first shloka, it was sindurarun vigraham. In the end, in the last shloka, it is sakumkum, means it is bright red. So from the orangish reddish hue of the rising sun till the dark red color of the setting sun. So these are the two differences between the first Dhyana mantra and the fourth Dhyana mantra, which we speak. So here, sa kum kum vilepana malik chumbi kasturikam, and so she is anointed with kumkum, so she is bright red in color, and she is also anointed with kumkum, which is mixed with kasturi. Now kasturi, what is kasturi? Kasturi means musk. So musk comes from the deer. We know about musk fragrance. Musk fragrance is very, very attractive. So you put those fragrance to attract someone. So mother is now anointed with kasturi, and she is anointed with kumkum. The reason, when we meditate upon these two features, she is all red, means she is all very pleasurable to see, and she is anointed with musk. Immediately our mind should be attracted towards the smell of musk, kasturi. It is so attractive that our mind will not go anywhere when we think of musk. So mother is not just colored, she is also very attractive in fragrance. So kasturi is giving that fragrance. Samandhasite kshana, with this form, red form, and wearing a kasturi on her, kasturi tilak probably on her forehead, and being very attractive and smelling so good, she has eyes again which are samandhasite kshana, means beautiful eyes, and now the eyes are smiling. So she has beautiful smiling eyes with a twinkle in her eyes. She is smiling. This is the form. Sasharacha papasha ankusham, and in her hand she is holding the sugar cane, as we have already discussed about it in previous shlokas. Sugar cane is the mind, and she holds an arrow, a noose, and the goad. Again, we have discussed about the noose and the goad previously. They are all used to control all the negative situations, the negative people in your life, and they are also used to remove all the negative thoughts or anything negative which is harming you, which is an obstacle in your path of spirituality. So to remove all that things, Divine Mother holds the arrow, the noose, the gourd, okay? And she is holding the mind. She is holding the sugar cane. Means she is holding the mind of the devotee so that the devotee is steadfast in his devotion. The devotee's mind does not go here or there, does not get carried away by material worldly affairs. And he can experience the highest point of spirituality. That's why Mother is so benevolent, so merciful. She is holding the mind of the devotee. That is indicated by the sugar cane in her hand. Asheshajanamohinim arunyamal bhushambaram. And her form is so pleasant that everybody are attracted to that form. Everyone's mind is attracted to that form. She captivates everyone. Arunyamal bhushambaram. And with this form, she is wearing a garland, a beautiful garland of red flowers. And preferably, those red flowers are like the Japakusum. It says, Japakusum bhasuram japavidhau smaredambikam. So she is wearing a garland of red flowers, red shoe flower, or anything with like that, which is red in color. And japa vidhau smaret ambikam. Here now they are saying, till now we were meditating on the form, now it says japa vidhau. By the vidhi of japa, by performing japa, we remember ambika. So in the last shloka, the dhyan mantra says that we remember divine mother by the practice of japa. So this is how all the four meditations have been. And again, I'm going to emphasize this one point. Dhyana mantra. Dhyan means to bring your attention, one-pointed concentration on the God or the Goddess of your worship. Since we are discussing Lalita Sahasranam, here the dhyana means to bring your mind to one-pointed focus on Sri Lalita Ambika. And how that is achieved? It is achieved by chanting this shlokas, dhyana mantra shlokas. What is there in the dhyana mantra shlokas? All the four dhyana mantra shlokas are describing the form of divine mother. So with every dhyana mantra, whenever you are trying, if you are trying to go near goddess or to experience the highest experience of spirituality or Lalita Sahasranam, with every dhyana mantra, start this little practice. First dhyana mantra, maybe first week, do the first shloka, and with the meaning of each and every word, try to visualize that form. Then second week, go to the second dhyan mantra, try to visualize that form. Then third week, go to the third dhyan mantra, try to visualize that form. Fourth week, go to the fourth dhyan mantra, try to visualize that form. In this way, all the four forms will start coming in your visualization. And this is how it is. So now whenever you go out, wherever you go out, whenever you see the sun or the moon, anything, slowly your mind will start relating it to the form of Divine Mother. So this is dhyana. Now, if you, normally what happens when we are in the world, our dhyana is somewhere else, our attention is somewhere else. But by the practice of such things, our dhyana will now again and again get attracted towards the beautiful form of Divine Mother. So all these shlokas have been given to us. They are describing the form and various colors and the fragrances. Like chandan has been mentioned, sindoor has been mentioned, flowers have been mentioned. So every little thing, you know, every little details should start coming in your mind when you are visualizing a form. So this is dhyana. Dhyana means bringing all your attention single-pointedly to the form or the name or the pastimes of the god or the goddesses whom you are worshipping. And here the dhyana mantra is bringing all my attention to the form, to the name, to the pastimes of Divine Mother Sri Lalita Ambika. So by this we end up the four dhyana mantras. And if you like this one, please feel free to comment. And if you have any questions, please write it down. And I hope you all like it and you share it with everybody. Thank you so much. Jai Gurudev.